Hey everyone, welcome back to some more Anachronox. We just made it to the Commerce Lounge, and now we're going to talk to everyone in here and see what it is that we need to get done. David Salsa, you cast an interesting shadow on the wall as you came through the hall. You ever notice what your silhouette looks like? I've heard some good things about you. Eurocon speaks highly, and I speak highly of Eurocon, so it's all good, right? Oh, this guy's part of the Resistance. He says you might make easy and do some resistance work for me while you're up here. He says you're a punch-out king, eager for the physical. That's now not me, no. So why don't you look over my shoulder? See that clone at the bar? You might remember wading through his aftershave. That squirt works for Detta. There's a heavy Gorian presence here on the station, less so in the commons where their decent folk mingle, but down in the root tubes, and beyond in the red light. Mostly he's here trying to smooth over relations with Data's drug connection. Gorians suspect Data knocked off one of their runners in the bricks for an easy profit. I figure he's got an ulterior motive for being here. I sure would like to know what it is. With the two of us and a little something in the squirt's drink, I'm sure we can find out. There's an apothecary, a drug dealer, who could provide a mild sleeping agent we could slip into his drink. I talked him down myself, but I'm afraid I'd lose squirt. If you're willing, sniff out the drug seller and drop back here with some sleep eye. I'll keep an eye on squirt. Don't worry, I'm watching a shadow on the wall. Okay, so he wants us to drug the little guy there. We need to find the drug dealer. I don't know who he is or where he would be, so we'll have to keep an eye open for him. Alright, well, let's talk to this gentleman. I just lost everything in a bad investment with some Gorian businessmen. My life is over. I'm sorry, Mr. Wibble. I can't even win at Zong. To be fair, no one can win at Zong, so that's perfectly fine. Greetings! I am Trader Bot Lamalo. Want a trade? Yeah, let me sell my wares. I can make a $6 profit selling the crystals here. Oh, wow. That's quite a hefty price on the Lumpha shells. Let's sell these. That's a 30 profit. Each one. And then we'll buy the vial of Vunulela, because that's worth 150 back at the other place. In fact, I'm going to just stockpile these, up to 30 of them. That sounds good. Wow, I'm going to go back to the very front spot and sell these. That's a lot of cash we're just going to pick up. But first, let's talk to everyone else except for the little guy who's here. Kill. Murder. Rage. That unbelievable Caesar. He took my sail. It was my sail. I earned it. What did he do for it? He stabbed me in the back. I was about to sign a multi-million loony deal with a client. The fees would have set me clean for months, but someone from my firm, my own firm, called him and told him it was a bad deal, turning it around to make a buck for himself. I can't believe it. I just can't believe it. This is a call to action. I'm not going to stand for this. I want to see some response here. I'm going to call my regional and tell him he needs to turn this thing around. I mean, the guy blew it out to make his own fees. We're in the same firm and he sabotaged me, stabbed me in the back quicker than... I just can't believe it. Oh, that sucks for that guy. Man. Look at him. Does he think we don't know? Does he think we're ever going to respect him? I'm talking about that little clone over there. He's one of Detta's kids. Accuse him of dirty money, and he'll cry foul, insisting Detta's gone legit. It's a same old story. Detta may be a big fish on Anachronox, where everyone's scrounging for money. But he'll find it's a very different story up here. Every couple of years, you get small-time hoods who make it big back in whatever armpit they crawled out from under. Now they want to exploit the wealth of Sender Station. But the Sender Economic and Trade Commission is much too tough a nut to crack for that class of man. I mean, look at his suit. Although you're rather shabby dressed, I can tell by your demeanor that you were once a person of wealth. You've got the look in your eye of a man who lost everything. As the Rebellions say, may you live in better times. Thank you. And yeah, I think we did indeed used to be quite a fat cat at one point. I lost them all. Twice. I bet you think I'm stupid. First I get hooked on the latest find. A fad. Tacos. Collect them all, they said. Everyone's got one, they said. Then the scandal, the internal memo leak that TACO stands for Totally Arbitrary Collectible Objects. They were laughing in the face of the consumer. We were all duped. Then the TACO burnings, the suicides. Some people had spent all their savings on them when the bottom fell out. But I kept mine. I kept them. I still love them. Then I fell on hard times, sold everything, my sled, my furniture, finally had to sell the collection for chump change. And then a year later, their popularity resurged. People were retro proud to own them, and everyone who had them made a mint. Not me. I was penniless. But I worked my way back up. I have money now. But there's no tacos on the market. Collectors hoard them. They're status symbols. Everyone I see and can't have mocks me. I need to heal this wound, this pain I've had from eating away at me so long. Could you help me? If you can find tacos for me, I'll reward you handsomely. I have contacts, please. Yeah, we have some tacos. How many tacos do we have, actually? Where's my collectibles? We have credit for one red BPG photo. And we have credit for 7 tacos. Looks like there's 20 total. You found a taco. Cool. Here's a little something in appreciation. Find some more. I'll give you something cooler. Heal grease complete. You found 5 tacos. Amazing. Here's a little something in appreciation. Find some more and I'll give you something cooler. 5 timeline tears. Awesome. I think 10's the next amount we'll get something else from. Pick your poison. I'll take some lemon fizz. Listen, if you're down on your luck, there's a lady at the Royal Penthouse Suites who's always looking for someone to do odd jobs for her. Her name's Contessa Shivrenstein. Tell her Muffly sent you. Wow, sure. I don't remember this. Let's do this. Okay, hello, sir. Look at Raya Raya bragging about his investments. I bet my portfolio's bigger than his. My investments are firmer and last longer. Well, it's not how much money you have, it's what you do with it that counts. Just saying. Another red shirt. Oh, I'm just waiting for a friend. Excuse me. Oh, he's related to probably some shady deal. Hello. Hey, you make opportunities for yourself. If you don't have the stomach for what it takes to succeed, you're a loser. You're not important in my life. I doubt you're very important in yours either. You carry your insignificance well. Tell me more, Master Raya. Wow, guy's pretty good at insulting people. Guess we'll talk to this gentleman. Hello, sir. I always wanted to be a mime, you know? I'm a banker instead. Life sucks. Yeah, it does. You know, you should always be trying to follow your dreams. I have been so lonely since my husband died. He had a brilliant mind. I miss his genius. No one could ever replace him, but sometimes I wish I could meet someone special. Oh, I'm just an old daydreamer. Never mind me. Can't we tell him about the scientist? Guess we can't. Goat knife. Yeah, I know the creep. Did he tell you I was scalping tickets? That jerk. Man, I don't do that stuff anymore. Will you let me alone? I don't know anything about it, and you're pissing off the clown. Look, there's a guy hiding in the shadows around the Lounge of Commerce, just up the way. Ask him. I got off my back already. Wow, that kid's scalping tickets. Fair enough. Hello, sir. That's the Lip Kinger 4 over there. They held a boffo conference last October. Their singing voices are pretty good too. They end every conference with a barbershop quartet rendition of Funny Money and Brebulin. Bet I could kill all 4 of them. Probably could. Just because a company's profit growth is sky high doesn't mean you should dive in, right? The price of stocks gotta jive too. You gotta invest fast and hard, baby. Run with the winners, deep 6 the losers, and quick. Invest in stock only if the price is right as rain. Invest aggressively. Investors poo-poo dividends, but when the market's in the gutter, I'm in the pink. Invest in dividends. You gotta buy contrary to public wisdom. No, really. Scoop up all them junk stocks nobody wants. Believe me, it pays. Invest in junk. Also, like they're saying different stuff. Okay, I want to actually cash in the stuff we just purchased, so let's pull back and do so. Oh, we want to do that odd job, too, for the person in the the royal suites. So first, we're gonna go all the way back here and just vendor some stuff so I have some more cash again. And then we'll go back to the royal suites. And see if we can get work from the one lady who's supposed to be there. Customs. I guess there's nothing we need to worry about in Anachronox. I guess there's a social thing as a passport either. Security weapons in town. That sounds like a place I want to be able to go in. Nope. Can't do so. Unless we can run up to the door and it will open for us. No, no luck. Okay. Interesting. I don't see any guards in the area, nor cameras. I guess I wouldn't know what they look like in the future. Let's sell our wares. So, it's a $70 profit for these. Nice. And we'll sell some crystals while we're here. It's actually only a $10 profit, but whatever. We're still making money. And then we will buy some shmoofa shells. And we'll take another 25 of these. And you could do this, most of the day if you wanted. Just endlessly farm money. Farm money? Just run back and forth between places. But that's, strikes me as being pretty boring to watch. So, no. And we shouldn't need that much cash anyway. Well, we will, but not enough to have to feel like you're forced to do that. Alright, so here we are back our... Oh, Quartercom Incorporated. Oh, I like their symbol. That's pretty nice, too. Quartercom Enterprises was the company guild name I used for a little bit in Champions Online, and I made a bunch of robots with one eye in the center. It's awesome. Choose the best. Choose Quartercom. Mullafay, we were roommates in college. She was quite a talented artist in those days. I often wonder why she's throwing her life away on a bartending job. Yeah, I've got a job for you if you're interested. Nothing too strenuous. I recently acquired a piece from a Brebulan art collector. He neglected to include a certificate of authenticity, which I assumed he had included in the exchange. He's leaving Sender Station tonight, so you need to find him soon. Can you locate him and get me the papers proving the authenticity of his piece? His name is Hermano. Okay, a Brebulan. The only one I can think of would be back at the docks. Oh, is this guy also a drug dealer? Let's talk to him really quick. Well, I don't scalp tickets now. Okay, he does not. I wonder why it's all falling apart here. The frame rate just drops dramatically right at that section. That's the Meadles. Here's some Brebulans, but I don't think these are them. Dude, what do you want? I only speak Brebulan. Can you say something in Brebulan? You're dumb. Look, we can't have a conversation. Please leave us alone until you get a clue. I don't see any Brebulans in this area. Alright, we'll have to keep our eye open. I'm trying to rack my brain where we saw another one. I don't think I have seen another. Is there one right here that I just ran past? No. Maybe he's in the area you haven't been yet. Oh, maybe he's inside the museum. Alright, we'll dash over there really quick, too. Ain't no salt. Okay, he's not the drug dealer we need either. We might have to come... I don't know. Don't know where I'm supposed to go. All right, is he in here? There is a Brebulan here. Let's see if this is him. Hello, good sir. Documents of authenticity. I don't remember making any sales this week. No, I am quite mistaken. There was that landscape I practically gave away to La Contessa Schirvenstein the other day. I didn't include any documentation. How odd. That's under procedure. How unprofessional of me. Why don't you check with my assistant? He's watching my bags at Gate 2 in Sender Station. Sure. So then now we do have to go back to the starport. There's a lot of this in this game, but there's a lot of this in most of the games I've played. A lot of running around. Where am I? This way. I don't mind running when it comes to stuff like this either. For new places, I definitely like walking there. And sometimes, like right now, I'll walk. Because this is a short little room. Then in wide open areas where there's not much to really see, which is weird for wide open areas, I'll walk there. So you want gate 2? Is this him? Between you and... Okay, no, that's not him. Oh, is it the robot? Maybe it's the robot. Hello, robot. Certificate of Authenticity. This is Bot Friday. For the Shrivenstein Stale. Just a moment, sir. I shall check my master's baggage. This isn't it. This isn't it either. Neither is this. Nope, not this one. Here it is. Oh, wait, that's not it. How about this one? Nope, that's not it either. It must be here somewhere. Is this it? No. What about this one? Yeah, here it is. Oh, wait. That's not it. Okay, yeah, no, this is it. Here you go. Sorry about that. Wrinkled dry cleaning bill. No, that's not it. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I give you an old dry cleaning bill? I thought it was a certificate. Just a moment. Here it is. It was stuck to the back of the dry cleaning bill. Sorry about that. Sucker. Nice. Bucker, it's a compliment. There are 130,000 in the ceiling. Count them all twice. Okay. Wow, that was interesting. So we could have walked back with the dry cleaning bill, and then maybe he would have left, and we might have failed that quest. I don't actually remember. Good thing I was paying attention to the item we got. That wasn't too much work for that. Okay, so... What are we doing, Tim? We're talking to her again. This is exactly what I was looking for. Good work. $50. Visit my gallery next time you're in Cortica. I never forget a face. Well, it wasn't much work for $50. I don't know. $50, we could earn $50 just as fast, or actually faster, by running between the two bots. Oh well, too late now. Let's go ahead and get out of here. So, let's go upstairs, and this time we'll make a turn in the other direction. We could buy the tickets, but I want to get the tickets without buying them, if I can. Oh, and we want to go back here. Oh, this is the guy in the this is a scalper, I guess. Hello, sir. Psst! Give me a buck. I'll let you in on a little secret. Here's a buck. This better be good. That outfit is really incredible. Thanks, man. Here's the secret. You know that door right around this corner? Well, it leads to the pumping station 7. But if you break left instead of right, there's a gate that leads to the root tables. Root tubes. Sender Station's underground substructure. If you take the root tubes all the way down to the core, you'll find a secret red light district where you can party till dawn. This is Boots. I've probably been to Red Light District more times than you have, buddy. Why don't you tell us something we don't know? Oh. Well, did you know the root tubes are infested with drug runners these days? It's become quite a little drug route ever since Duke Deuce lost the Gorian drug wars a few months ago. With all the heating ducts, it's hotter than hell. Leather just seems to soak the heat right up. So there you have it. How was I supposed to know you already knew about the Red Light District? It's not my fault you were dumb enough to give me a dollar. Fair enough, sir. Fair enough. Oh, I also... So, that will lead to the road tubes, and I definitely want to go there. But first, I want to talk to everyone else up here. He said to wait for him here. He promised to come back. That was 2 days ago. He was a dashing young pilot. He swept me to his world and said he would take me away from this place. I believed them. I bought 2 tickets to Democritus. We were going to start a new life there together. He took the tickets and said to wait for him here while he got the luggage. He'll come for me. I'm sure he will. Hello, PAX officer. I remember the first time I bashed a punk's head in. It was the summer of 23. We were quelling a spat of civil unrest on Cortica. Man, those were the days. I remember the feel of the whack as my arm absorbed the impact. I kept going for the eye, that single unblinking eye, clubbing it until it cried blood. I always remember that wonderful feeling. Every time I see one of those one-eyed bastards walking around, I think for the first time. Sometimes it's hard to resist the temptation to relive that moment. Okay, story's over. Hit the road, Jack. 2 months? There's no way we can get the stabilizers properly installed in that short amount of... Shh! Get it done. That's ridiculous. How do you expect to get quality work from the folks who haven't had a day off or decent night's sleep in 6 months? You can't just... Shh! Get it done. But you're being unreasonable. Don't you see that? Shh! Get it done. Oh, sod off. Get it done yourself. I quit. Where does that guy get off treating his workers this way? Without us, he's nothing. What are you doing? Are you getting it done? No. Well, I'm hoping to get it done. Whatever it is. Hello, sir. A lot of people rag on Quartercom. But the truth of the matter is, we've made it possible for the masses to live in comfort for relatively cheap. So eat me. Yeah, that's right. Sure. Interesting way to look at it, I suppose. That's Warren Whedon. He's leading a pseudo-religion whose faith is in money. Currency is their god. What else is new, right? He's trying to recruit converts by speaking free today. But look out. Once he gets his meat hooks into you, he's stringing you along until you're in the poorhouse. What a crackpot. Hey, you interested in investing in bipedry meat? No, not really. And when the great misfortune befalls you, your only protection will be your solvency. Save up, my flock. No, make no mistake. Whatever form it comes, it will be a blight upon us all. Only two moments are inevitable: death and the cataclysm. And when the great okay, so how about that? He is espouting nonsense. Or not. When misfortune happens, you definitely do need cash to handle it. Depending upon the misfortune. Generally, though, money will help in whatever situation you find yourself in. Okay, so we are running all the way back here. I think we're going to the Vendomart. And I think there's stuff for sale here. Oh, they're a Trader Bot. Hello, Trader Bot. What are you selling? I'm Trader Bot Vince. I've got the best deals, and I'm looking for quality items. Hello, sir. May I be of assistance? Yeah, let me see your wares. Oh, this guy. Oh, wow. He'll buy Shunfu shells for 100. And it looks like the bongos are what I want from him. So let's buy a bunch of bongos. 25. Now let's sell the Shunfa shells for 90. Wow, that's a pretty good profit right there. And done. Alright, what we got here? So, hello, miss. That's a giant doll. Don't be fooled by the hype. Megalophaliac Wendy is nowhere near as good as Megalophaliac Fred. Not only does Fred come with 40 collectible containers, but he also sings a special Megalophalix family theme song in 12 languages. Pretty remarkable, wouldn't you say? You need therapy. I need therapy? You're the one who's thinking of buying Megalophalix Wendy. I don't talk to mean people, even cute ones. Oh, guess we had a chance. So what's for sale here? What do we see? Looks like a shield cell, a pistol. I can't even see the other things. Let's see. Quartercom power belt cell. This fine power cell will service any local energy-based device. Just charge it up, slap it on your belt, and your power needs are handy as hands. Also look for a special edition center station shield cell, providing both power and protection. Specs: output 100 energy, max shield, none. Oh, so this thing just gives you energy, but no shield. Oh, hey, but we can buy anything we want here. All right, cool. We already have a Viston 3 beam, so we don't need to buy another one of them. In fact, oh, sure, how buying works with your equipment. Do you see Boots' face? He's indifferent for this item. Grumpos and both Palatine are facing the other way. They're not interested in this at all. Boots thinks this is okay, so he's not really interested in that. Everyone else thinks it's okay. We already have one. Pavli likes this. Krumpos likes this. Everyone likes Megalophallic Wendy. I guess we'll buy one. Anti-Twinkie Amulet protects from Winky in battle. Blood Filter Fascia protects from poison. The Allure Bland block increases block one level. Protects Winky and Nuts. Protects against Slow and Bindle Bags. Oh, Life Crusher Life Light. Fatima shines her light on local creatures and objects. We'll take one of them. We have some money. And I think that's it. Is that all I really want? I probably should buy something else. Let's buy a Turbo Alert Wrist Pincher. Actually, wouldn't mind having another Eluder Band. Let's do this. Oh, hello. We could have actually interacted with this thing. Maybe probably could have made the prices cheaper, couldn't we? Well, it's too late. Let's do this first. So, party. Equip. All right, so he has a pre-owned shield cell. Let's give him the Turbo Alert. And you're already using the Luda Band. We have a Ballista's Bracelet. Then we'll give you also an Eluder Band. In a looter band. Pretty good beat block. Alright, let's give this a try. Oh god. Gotta get over there quick. Ooh, come on, Tim. I think we did it. Alright, thank god. Wow. Woof. What are we stealing? Oh, hey! Scientist outfits, or like a white suit.
Tighten your belt, sunshine. We got a bird to catch.
I guess this'll work. I wasn't done in there though, game. Why'd you put me out here? I didn't realize we could purchase that there. I thought we found that from someone else. Okay, that really works out then. I wonder if we can actually interact with this. Hey, this data link's busted. Okay, so no. Let's go up the stairs and see what... Oh, gotcha. So you can actually see what's for sale in all these locations. That's a pre-owned shield cell. Looks like there's other things here. It's probably just looter bands or what have you. Oh, hello. Who are you, sir? Everyone thinks I'm a pushover. Guards always pick on me. They beat me up and stick their finger in my lunch. I was trying to buy a heel grease, but this weird prism was jammed up in the delivery slot. Any idea what it is? This is a holy prism from the School of Order. I can meditate with this at the Pay to Pray downstairs. Cool. Thank you. Yeah, thanks for taking my prism, man. No problem. Holy crap! Always explore everything. I thought we got one of those later. This is great. Okay, so that will unlock a new ability for Grumpos. Let's go to the Pay to Pray. Okay, Grumpos, we need you here. Hello there, sir. Welcome to Pay to Pray. The relics of 3,600 different religions are housed here within our bank, Vault Secure, Bulletproof Pray Pod. Trademark. For only a reasonable fee of 50 loonies, you can be put into the presence of a holy relic from the religion of your choice. From a Gorite Glory Tether to a Brebulan Saint Spine, we guarantee a quality communion with an authentic relic, no matter how obscure your faith. Would you like to purchase quality time with our paid to pray? I'll meditate with the Hexagonal Prism. What a dazzling prism. We graciously accept it as valid proof of your involvement with the School of Order. Step up to the pray pod. The black cube of perfection will rotate into position shortly. My meditations have proven fruitful. Heal field. Oh, awesome. Let's see what that's like next battle we get into. Employee only, huh? Nope. Not opening that one. Probably just some sort of other prism in there, maybe. Guess you sit here if you can't afford to actually meditate inside? Is that how that works? This is a pretty awesome idea. Wonder if churches will be like this in the future. Oh, nice. We've got some holy water on our way out, too. I'm assuming. Yeah, you can totally miss, like, important stuff. Or, well, I guess it's not important to have heal field, but it certainly is useful. Especially because we won't have any access to healing stuff outside of heal greases for quite some time. Okay. Let's try... We need the drug dealer, and I don't know where he's located. Are you him? You didn't... Naughty sent you. Why did you say so in the first place? You need tickets? How many? Where? What about a little something to spike a drink? Yeah, I think I know someone who can get you the hookup. Find Slick Jawmin in the root tubes underneath Pumping Station 7. The entrance is unmarked door to the pack station. Alright, let's do that then. Actually, where's the Sen dormitory? Let's do this really quick. Oh, no, we'll be back for that. It occurs to me that an item I need is probably out at night, and we can't make it night unless we go to sleep. So, I think... I'm pretty sure that's the case. Oh, and hey, is this... Oh. Maybe it's not the case. I don't know. We'll find out, I guess. Alright, let's go down to the row tubes. If we're going to explore the row tubes, we better change out of these lab coats. It's filthy down there. Nope, there's a bug pile there. Oh, hello, Time Minder. Yeah, sure, we'll pet the Time Minder. Looking on time anyway. 105. Okay, 30 minutes so far. Not bad. We'll have explored, I think, all of this location in about 30 minutes. Oh, holy crap, another Trader Bot. Hello, sir. I'm Trader Bot Rollo. Bucker Walk. Well, I want to see what your wares. I guess the Vistrina cubes are what he's selling for the cheap. So we'll purchase 25 of these. And that's good. I think we fight some new enemies. I think we fight Gorians down here. Several different types. So that's a tougher one. I guess we might as well fight them. Let's just walk out there. Wow, that was a massive hit. Oh, I forgot he's pretty agile. Nice, that was a good hit though, Grumpos. You gotta get closer? Alright, we'll get you closer then. I like how most of the enemies use, like, moves you see professional wrestlers using. Wow, 230, holy crap, our shield cells absorbing some of that. Oh, wow, holy crap, he's nuts! He'll attack a random person when his turn comes up. Wow, we could lose someone here. Especially if we keep missing. Oh my god, this is terrible. Well, I should have moved away. Grumpus wouldn't attack me. I have to hope he attacks him instead. Nope. Oh, wow, Boots is gonna go down. Let's get you out of there. This way he'll be forced to attack Grumpus. Actually, it looks like that has some range to it. Let's use Windmill Dash. Oh, you missed! Holy crap! Time for Heal Field, then. Oh, what? We won? That was really weird. Okay. We earned 700 experience. And Heal Field worked, so I don't understand what happened right there, but I guess the game felt bad it was gonna... This is kind of awesome. This is definitely a bug. I don't understand this, but I've never seen this happen ever, and this is too incredible to not walk around like this. And Heal Field looks like it healed all of us completely, so that's kind of awesome. We can't open that door. Oh, hello, there's an interface socket here. We should totally see what that does. Actually, we probably have to use that to open up the way down. Guess you could show up here without Palutena. Well, that one wasn't so bad. Grubbus is still sparking stuff with his staff. We should also keep an eye open for anything we might be missing. That heal grease, for example, was off in the area. And are we all healed completely? We are. Wow, that is incredible. Yeah, the special moves are kind of overpowered. They trivialize a lot of the combat or what have you in this game. I probably shouldn't complain about that, though. We would have consumed a large amount of heal grease otherwise. I saw that. There's a Glodent or something back there. Yep. Alright, let's get this guy. Hello. Yeah, so that effect is called Nuts, the one with all the little cubes rotating around them, pulsing above someone, and they attack a random target. They may even move on their turn rather than attack someone. I think that the yellow shield on us must be the protection from Nuts, so Boots can't have it on him, and neither can Palutena due to the items we have on us. Oh yeah, see those pipes? Those are worms, actually. We're about to fight them. We get a little closer down here. They actually go pretty quickly, but they can't take very many hits. Ooh, 131 damage. Good for him. They die really... Oh, they don't die to a single hit. And that was him missing. The pipe he summons just misses entirely. Oh, look, they have little faces inside the pipes. Wow, they're susceptible to his shock claw. Oh, they can poison us. How about that? So they have a ranged attack, too. Looks like Boots is the only one that can't one round one of these guys. Pal, you should build this. Use your claw at range, I think you can. Well, that was awkward. Oh, he didn't miss him. He actually hit the guy for like 1,000-something damage. I just so happened to get off the Fatima screen. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, so we're able to actually do something before combat ends. That explains the effect that happened. I should look to do that with Grumpos if I can. So that's totally a glitch. I shouldn't take advantage of that. I wonder if I'll start with the Fatima screen in play. Man, this place really is dirty. We're going down to the red light district, but I don't think we'll be able to enter it yet. Quite a few areas like this, rusted, decrepit-looking locations that we'll be adventuring in. Mental note, don't say melt to this guy. Looking verily for flavored goods, your eyes wide for consumption. Sporific wanderer dust, for sleepiness and drink, purchase for mere 100 loony. Excellent. Dissolving quickly in alcohol. No taste, no color. Brain will wander until sleeps. And we can buy a ticket from him if I want to, but I'd still like to get the tickets for free. It's just, I don't know, it's just more my thing. Oh, there's someone down here as well that Investigator Rock wants us to find, so we should keep an eye open for something suspicious down here, too. Oh, like this. Hello. Oh, we'll take the Glowden. And a picture of the destroyed panel. Might have had something to do with it. Hey, that guy was right. Someone shot this panel apart. Idiot. That means we can't go down here until it's fixed. Someone fry the panel that opens this door. Okay, well, so much for going down into the red light district then. But I didn't think we could go down there anyway. So, that's it for this area. At the moment, at least. I think later on you'll fight multiples of those Gorgon we fought before. The area becomes much tougher. Nuts protection is one of the more important ones you can have, since there's no damage reduction from what your companions do, and so being smacked upside the head for like a few thousand damage later in the game, holy crap, that will just slaughter you. It's fine when you're doing it to the enemy, it's not fine at all when your companions are wasting their turns, not killing the thing, destroying you instead. Thankfully, the Boge abilities are simply way, way overpowered. Okay, so I guess, well, we'll go now and use the drug tablets. We'll visit the trader bot and pick up more of the Finistrum vials, whatever they're called. And then I guess we'll be ready to go? No, I still need another ticket. And I don't want to buy one. Alright, we'll rest at the Sun Dormitory, which I think will allow it to be nighttime outside. I think. And then we'll be able to... I think a flower blooms at night that we can get or pluck? Something of the sort? Oh, unless... No, I think I just didn't notice it back in the... Okay, I'm being a little dumb. Wow, I'm not being dumb. I just never realized it. I need a flower, and there's one next to the scientist. That's right. That's right. Okay, so we'll do all this now. We'll save the game, and then we'll arrive on Sunder Station. And then we'll pick up the next session then. Okay, well, we are done. Let's go ahead and get on out of here. Okay, so we have the drink we need. Let's go ahead and see if we can do this. Oh, there were no tacos down there, were there? None that we saw. Probably should keep my eye open a little more. Alright, let's see if she'll poison his drink for us. Pick your poison. Sluice. Easy go. Really? You'll buy me a drink? Hear that, girl? This gent says he'll buy me a drink. I'll put it on his tab. Here you go, Ace. Down the hatch. Oh yeah, that's what I've been talking about. This is some strong paint. Man, it's been a day. Quite a day. One of those days. One of them long days. It's hard, you know, having to face those businessmen. You know they all think you're a chump because you work for Detta. Some played off, most of them are rude. Hey, this is some good swill, thanks again. Detta, he ain't such a bad egg. He took us in, Alvin and the rest of us clones. Treats us like people, you know? That Detta's got a big heart. He's even nice to the floaters. He appreciates talent, doesn't matter if someone's got wings or if someone's a clone. Not only am I a clone, I got a big metal fist. Holy crap, I'm almost done with my drink. Ain't it easy, you know, when you're a clone? We're all different peoples, you know? That's what no one understands about us. At all. Are you warbling? Well, looky here, there was a note in his inside pocket. Shorty's note. Well, that's what we wanted. Resistance work completed. Hello, sir. Let me have a look at that note. Interesting. Dad's got some business with someone on Sunder named Zuriwin. Too bad we don't have agents on Sunder. Can't seem to get anyone past the brain bouncer character. Hell, we even have the keyword to make contact. Gemini. Oh well, at least Dad won't be getting whatever Zuwin's delivering. But we're going there, so I'm going to pass on the word about Gemini and Zuwin. A little good to do us, but at least Detta won't be getting whatever Zuwin's delivering. Okay, let's, Oh, this the traitor bot. Where was that? Here you are. Let's sell the wares? Nothing here I want. Let's see his wares, and let's just buy as many of these as we can. That 30's good. Now we'll head back to the detective with the pictures we took. Maybe they'll come in handy. Then we'll go to the fancy hotel. And then I think we'll call the session then. We'll do the last of it in the next bit and arrive on Sunder. Hello, Mr. Rook. Ouch. Yeah, that's the Tetra smuggler, right? Looks like he ran across more action he could handle. So the door panel was shot up. Is that right? Smells like an ambush to me. How could he miss that often with such a state-of-the-art cannon at close quarters like that? This doesn't make any sense. Well, at least I can stop following up on the safe house leads. Thanks a lot, man. Thanks for staying on top of things, man. Reminds me of the old days. Listen, here's a little something to help you stay frosty. I've been using it instead of coffee to stay alert. Amulet of Alertness. Back to the grind, man. I'm gonna sniff out some new leads. Amulet of Alertness. Protects from consciousness effects in battle. I think that means every ability, but I'm not sure. We'll find out if we have a multicolored shield on our character. That's actually really strong if that is one of them. Alright, hello, Sender Trader Bots. Let's sell. Sell Red Ziffin? What the heck is a Red Ziffin Berry? Where? Silver Leaf? Red? I don't understand what these things are, nor where we got them, nor where the other thing was that we had originally. I think that's a bug of some sort. So we definitely want to sell these. And I guess the Bonglugos? I don't remember how much we actually bought those for. We'll hold on to the rest of them, in case I see an obvious good purchase. We'll buy 20 of these. We'll be back often to Sender Station, so it's not really a waste of money just holding on to a few of these. Okay, so where are we going now? What do we need to do? Oh, that's right, back to the hotel. You know, I think I realize when I run and when I don't. So if we're doing fetch quests, I have no problem running from spot to spot, generally. When I'm traveling from spot to spot for story-related things that aren't fetch quests, I generally enjoy walking instead. The fetch quests I view as a time sink, as it were, which they are. And to speed up the time sink, I will run from spot to spot. Yes. Yep, I never noticed it before. Okay. Wow, I was surprised I remembered it was here. I would have given up and had to buy a ticket. Here's a rose right here. Let's take the rose. Found a lovely rose. I think we might know who to give this to. Maybe. There are two girls here, I think, who would at least say hello to him if we give them the flower. There's her, and there's her. She seems like the better match, so let's go ahead and give her the flower. If she'll accept it. It's been a long time. It's been a long time. Sorry to bother you again, but I need to give you this rose. Hey, don't look get too excited, it's not from me. So I'm a sharp-looking gent staying down the block at the penthouse suites. His name's Dr. Brywell, if you want to thank him in person. But you better hurry, he's leaving for Sunder pretty soon. A romantic doctor from Sunder? At the penthouse suites? Really? I think I will thank him in person, excuse me. Okay, we actually have to wait for her to get there, so... Is there anything else I want to do while I'm in the area? I really need to do anything else. I guess we'll just follow her from a distance. Actually, we're faster than her. I love how people walk in this game. Kind of ridiculous, but whatever. It works. Your arms all floppy. Everyone here has giant hands, too. Like enormous hands. But hey, you know, you do with the best with what you got. And by that, I mean... the game engines at the time. This was state of the art way back then. I think. I hope it was. I think it was. Don't mind us, we're just following you to make sure you go there, so then we can ask the doctor about his ticket, so we don't have to pay for any of it. Yep. This isn't creepy at all. Would this actually work? In real life, you think? I don't think so. It is a video game. Well, that was pretty cool. She entered and looked around the place. That was a really nice touch. Man, I like that. She didn't immediately just walk over to him. She had to enter the place, look around, and find him. And that guy's just mispositioned, which is why he's hovering in the air like that. Alright, now we're gonna pretend some time has elapsed. Could you excuse us? Here, take my ticket to Sunder and sell it. I have further research to do here. Oh, woo-woo! I'm sure he does. Okay, we got the tickets. Now we gotta get on that brain train to Sunder somehow. No problem. I guess we'll do this now. We'll make it to Sunder, and then we'll save the game there. Alright, so... back to the gate over here. Yep, we're all done with Sunder Station. I can't think of anything else that we need to do. And we don't need to go back to Anachronox at the moment. So, let's... oh, wow, let's press on. Investigator Rook has left. Anyways, we entered any new place that require a load. Or maybe he left and we entered this area after completing that quest for him. Okay. You seem familiar. Were you at the conference in Asagan last month? Never mind how preoccupied I look. I am always happy to chat with a fellow colleague. If I seem a bit distracted, that's only because my thoughts are buried in my latest project. It's very exciting. What is it? From the last 15 years, I've been conducting studies on temporal anomalies. It's just about all I can think about. I'd love to take the next brain train to Sunder and get back to work, but my Scientifica Association grant is dwindling. Without more funds, my research will go unfinished. You know how it is. Even the noble pursuits of science are subject to the whims of bankers and investors. Well, you better get going. The brain train departs shortly. Aren't you cute? I could use a little assistant. Well, my project had the budget. Now we have the information we need. Oh, God. In fact, we're just gonna start over. It's generally better for you to start over than try to keep going if you mess up right away. Like I just did again. Now on this one. We did the right thing? Yes, we did. Perfect. There's only one path to solve those, and if you get it wrong, it costs you so much time to drop the current piece you're holding and grab another one. Or at least I'm not swift enough to do it. There's no hotkeys either for those, so you can't just hit a button and immediately grab a different tile to use. Man, Grepos looks quite the part, doesn't he? Hello, sir. Thank you, and enjoy your flight. Alright, let's see what this brain bouncer is like.
Extrapolate, if you will, Schoenhausen's theory of caustics by reflection.
Oh, that's easy. The cut caustic envelope of a moving line can be determined by...
uh-oh.
I'm sure I'll get through, but I think you're stuck.
Maybe they'll ask me an easy one.
Characterize gravity theories in relation to universally coupled scalar fields in the context of Dirac's large number hypotheses.
Oh, well. I didn't really want to go to Sunder anyway.
Don't worry, Mr. Boots. Let him ask his questions. I'll take care of everything, you'll see.
I love how they handled this in the game. You've been to Sunder. You know the drill. Credentials can be faked. Knowledge can't. explain the Dite's molecular viscosity process, the fluoroaquifer systems in the Tentix system. Well, that's easy. I wrote an article on the process for that scientific journal. If my memory serves me, the key to the processes is the 40,355 flange housing ends in the polypolyon baffles. The organic solvents reserve turbidity levels in the abrasion-resistant fluorocarbons. Molecular sieves synthesize thermal inorganic polymers through solid phase extraction. Finally, molecular adhesion occurs with a small aliquot of organonitrogen herbicides. Very succinct. I'd like to read the article someday. Have a nice flight, Doctor. You can say whatever you want. It's correct, basically, with Grumpos. I don't know if it's actually correct or if he just lied. You've been the Sunder. You know the drill. Credentials can be faked. Knowledge can't. Illustrate Benzimir's phygologenic protocols and biomechanical post-asphyxiation processing. Excuse me, do you speak Awugin by any chance? I'm afraid Awugin is not one of the 23 languages I know. Why? Well, my master is an Awugin from the Asagon system. He speaks an obscure provisional dialect. Luckily for you, I can serve as his translator today. Remember, Palatine downloaded the entire science database available to, I guess, everyone in the world. Very well, as long as your translation skills are adequate. Illustrate Benzimir's phylogenic protocols in biomechanical post-fixiation processing. Iyo tikimewa guap siki pipen. Initially, periodic superconductors buffer the cellular dehydrates, precipitating fixative hybridization. RP Dividofer Shaz Monito Frick Frack Zinya Hishtok. Meanwhile, methacrylate embedding results in guandinium denaturans. Wow, I can't even pronounce half of these things. Tubi ubi wala nubi abanaba. Cellulose chromatography enables transmigration of paraformaldehyde wiring and Guyon's fixative. Eo play! In conclusion, supernat conductors process post-fixation perfusion fixed tissues. Humph. They know their science on Awuga. You may proceed. Such a great idea, pal had. What are you gonna do? They got past ya. Okay, well, we made it. see, is there a time minder around? I don't see any. Oh, crap. All right, then I guess we'll talk to people here, too. Hello, sir. There have been reports of huge biomechanical vultures feeding off space debris in the sector. If we're lucky, we'll see one. Keep an eye open. We should probably have Grumpo see us. I wonder what the in-flight movie is. I hope it's Biomechanical Cell Division 2. My kingdom for a bag of peanuts. I want some peanuts. Do you want some peanuts? I'll get them for you. Wait. Don't say anything. I'm not feeling too well. Sunder spike travel makes me sick. Stop it. You're gonna make me throw up. I don't want that to happen. Oh, you're in the way. There we go. Hello, heel grease. We're already past heel grease usage. We now kind of only want heel grease pluses. Okay, interact with any of this stuff? Doesn't look like it. My kingdom for a bag of peanuts. Stop it! I guess they're hitting her up, chatting her up. Where did Dr. Shupton go? Be like everyone else. Drink more Deirdre's cola. Must think harder. Dr. Enbert Alstein instead of Albert Einstein. Mrs. Front's escort service. Good old fashioned fun. That's an interesting logo for that. Hope you like talking to people. It's funny. You got one of those faces. You make me want to talk to you. I bet you get a lot of that. Strangers telling you secrets they wouldn't tell their own therapists. Do you think I look like a movie star? No. I hoped you would come over here. I noticed you wearing a Corticom Linguinator. I've been working on a side project that might just interest you. You see, most consumer linguidators on the market today are incredibly clumsy, especially that Corticom knockoff you're wearing. The translations are ungrammatical, and unknown slang even causes certain models to crash. Most importantly, if you come across languages that aren't already pre-programmed to the conversational module, you're sick out of luck. Now, just imagine the Rosetta Stone of linguidators, one that translates alien languages that are not in the linguidator translation table. Here's how it works. First, the unknown languages run through a series of very complicated algorithms which check for recurring phonetic patterns and cross-reference them against a Berzac-Finley lingua cipher. Then the actuator spits out an on-the-fly translation. Simple in theory. Yeah, it took 15 painstaking years of development. Here, plug this adapter into your linguinator. Do me a favor and report any bugs you might encounter. Wow, nice. This breakthrough is going to win me the Wed in Harmony Prize for Science. We're on final approach to Calsum Starport, where they're enjoying partly cloudy skies and a high of 82 degrees. We hope you enjoy your stay on Sunder, and we thank you for flying on the Brain Train. Alright, well, we made it to Sunder. Let's leave the docking bay and see if we can find Dr. Ro Bowman. Now, we heard a little bit about her, and that she is in the Rainbow... I forget what it's called now. Oh, okay, here's Fatima to tell us. Alright, fellas, I did a center-net search for Dr. Ro Bowman and found out some stuff. Boots, remember when I went on that self-help kick after reading a book called Mistech Awakes? Just a few months before I died? Well, the person we're looking for wrote it. I can't find a listing in the Colossum Scientist Directory. The only reference I could find was in a six-month-old shipping log which shows laboratory equipment for a R. Bowman shipped to a building called the Rainbow Sanctuary. All searches for Rainbow Sanctuary come up blank. I'm afraid you're on your own, boys. Well, we have an idea, or I have an idea where it might be or what it's located as, I think. But first, I would like to stop here. So I will stop here, everyone. When we come back, I will be in front of a time minder, and we will begin exploring Sunder. And I'll see you guys then. Take care, and thanks for watching.